Due to the illness of Rebecca Herbst, today the role of Elizabeth Weber will be played by Martha Madison.
Elizabeth, did Dr. Somberg leave me the files on his new HIV patient?
Yes.
Right here. Thank you.
Well, I see Emma's been busy in daycare.
Yes, she is going through the whole express yourself through pasta phase right now.
Yes. Clay was Jake's medium. He made me this lump once with like a peg in it for me to hang my keys on. He must have seen me lift them every morning. You know what that kid lacked in creativity, he made up for an observation.
I'm not sure if that's going to be possible. That's going to be a difficult procedure.
I couldn't think of a better way to start the day.
What about you, Elizabeth? I got a high-grade glioma that needs to be done tomorrow morning. So if you're ready to get back in the OR, I'd love to have you on the team.
There you are. Guess they do work.
And what worked?
Oh, it's an old Irish wife's tale. If you're worried about someone coming home, you make rosemary cookies. It's probably just the effort that makes the time pass, though you never know. Want one?
Maybe later.
Crossed my mind that maybe you'd gone back looking for Luke.
I was just out driving around.
Any place in particular?
No. That was the point. No place to go, no one to answer to. No offense.
Antiquan.
I was just trying to see if I could get my mind off of everything that happened with my dad, you know.
Did it work?
Patient's in her 30s. She came in last week complaining
yes.
of...
Thank you. I would love to get back into the OR.
That sounds good. We'll put it together. We'll put the pictures up and we'll take a look.
Can we just hold that thought for 1 second? Family conference.
You don't think that I'm ready to get back into the OR because of my meltdown the other day. Steve, I walked into my house and saw all of my son's things in boxes. Like I wasn't supposed to think about him anymore. Like an empty room was going to make me think of
Lizzie,
him any
less.
Lizzie,
it's the fact that you forgot that you asked me to pack his things that bothers me.
Okay, I'm sorry. You've been wonderful and supportive, and I completely flipped out on you.
The first 10 apologies were more than sufficient. I love you. I'm not judging you, but there's a lot of pressure in the OR. And that's the kind of place that you have to be completely detached and in total control.
I understand that. And listen, I appreciate your concern. But the OR is where I feel like I'm in control. So be good for me, okay? What's that?
My dad's cigar lighter. Took it from him after he tried to torch the casino.
That wouldn't have stopped him.
It's quite the legacy, isn't it?
That's not all you've got. You have good memories.
I don't know if he woke up every morning and took note of the nearest exits.
Say what you will, but from what Luke said, he loved you.
Well, you guys talked about me?
In passing. It wasn't a lengthy debate.
What did he say? Oh, that's great. You can't repeat it. Can't be good.
Oh, it wasn't all bad.
What was it then?
He said it out of love.
Just tell me.
All right then. Luke said that you were shackled to your past and that the best thing for you would be to break free.
Yeah, he's one to talk. You remember when I took off from home as a kid and we spent a few nights under the pier?
Cold, damp clothes, sand in my hair, yeah. How could I forget? Never felt safer or happier.
You know, that was the first time that I lost my dad. I saw flaws that were just... inconceivable. to me, and now they're all coming back.
But you guys managed to start over.
I don't think we can this time.
Because of Jake.
But not in the way you think.
I don't understand.
I went after him. Found him in Florida, where he and Bobby grew up.
In that place?
Yeah, in the whorehouse. And I tried to talk to him, tried to tell him how much I love him, that I want him to come home, and it didn't matter. He just wasn't interested. In fact, he acted like a complete bastard.
Luke has his own way of thinking and loving. Maybe he was just trying to push you away for your own good.
Yeah, I thought that at first. But then he said something that...
That what?
I don't want to repeat it. I don't want to hurt you.
Tell me.
Dad said that killing Jake liberated him. What the hell am I supposed to do with that?
Luke actually said those words? That killing Jake liberated him?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, don't get me wrong. Dad's sorry for hitting Jake on the road that night. I mean, it's something he's going to live with for the rest of his life.
Then how is he liberated?
Well, being beyond redemption, as he put it, allows him to turn his back on everything.
That's no way to live.
No, but what does it matter? Because he's just claiming that it's who he's always been. The kid who grew up in a whorehouse and doesn't give a damn about anyone.
Listen, I've tried really hard not to blame your father for anything that's happened. But I don't know if I can forgive him for doing this to you. It's just wrong and cruel.
Well, I have to own up to the part that I've played in all this.
What part?
I pushed Dad to admit that he's an alcoholic and that he needs to get treatment.
It doesn't give him the right to give up on you. Or himself.
No, it's easier than facing what he's done. See, that's what this all comes down to. I pushed Dad too far, and he's taking the easy way out.
Lucky, this is not your fault. Nobody blames you.
Well, maybe they should.
Lucky! I didn't even think this through. I didn't even know if you would be home. It was just kind of an impulse. If you're busy,
Mom, come in.
It's Lucky.
Okay.
It's everything, really. Starting with the night that I let Jake walk out the front door.
Okay, what's happening right now?
Lucky found his dad. It didn't go well. He asked Luke to come back, but Luke wasn't interested, and then he said some really horrible things.
That's Luke's way.
Not with Lucky. Not like this. And now Lucky's flipping it all around, and he's blaming himself.
For what?
For defending Luke? For failing to take care of Jake?
Oh, no, he did. He did take care of Jake. You know, when we all made that decision,
Nobody could have known how it would all turn out.
You, out of all of us, still have that clear picture. So, I was wondering, hoping, really, that maybe you could talk to Lucky.
About what?
You're Jake's biological father. You could try and lessen Lucky's guilt, you know, tell him you forgive him.
Yeah, but Lucky didn't do anything wrong.
But he doesn't believe that. Jason, Lucky's in a really bad place. He needs help.
I've told him that. Look, I don't think that I can help Lucky. The one person who can truly help him is you.
Too much has happened.
Yeah, but the two of you are still connected.
By our son.
By more than children. When it comes right down to it, there's never really been anybody else for Lucky. But you.
More to the truth than telling him how I feel.
And you gotta tell him everything. You know, no more decisions made for somebody else's good.
I'm just afraid that whatever I say will be too late to do any of us any good.
What the hell happened here?
This is, farewell present for my dad.
Okay, let's get you out of here before someone sees you, okay? Let's go. Let's go.
I want to see it.
Let's go. Get in the car, Lucky.
Dude, don't do this. Come on.
No, you don't do this. Get in the car, Lucky. Lucky! Get in the car. I'll throw you in the trunk.
What are you even doing here?
I'm actually trying to save a friend, so why don't you just keep your mouth shut for a minute? Yeah, I'd like to report a house fire. 24 Royal Street. No. I don't think anyone's lived there for quite some time. Send someone as soon as possible, please. Detective Falconeri, PCPD, thank you. You sure no one saw you?
No.
And no one knows you were coming here?
Nope.
Okay, where the hell are you going?
Where was the fireworks?
What are you talking about? What are you talking about, fireworks? Like, you just set a house on fire. Okay, the law tends to frown on arson, especially when it's committed by a cop.
Give me that speech. It's an abandoned house.
Who cares? You don't care about losing your badge, apparently.
Something my dad would appreciate. I mean, not as much as watching the place burn. Did you hear that?